स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे वी विल स्टडी द इक्वेशन ऑफ ए लाइन इन स्पेस। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइंस इन टू डायमेंशन। वी शैल नाउ स्टडी द वेक्टर एंड कार्टेशियन इक्वेशंस ऑफ ए लाइन इन स्पेस। In our last chapter, that is in vector algebra, we studied the how to find the vector representation of a line. Suppose you have this line and we know how to represent this line in vector form, xi plus yj plus zk. Or else if you have two points, say x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, and this is joined by a line having some direction, then how to write the vector representation of this line? That is x2 minus x1 I vector plus y2 minus y1 j vector plus z2 minus z1 k vector. This is the vector representation of this line. This is not the equation of the line. This is the vector representation of this line. Okay? And also, suppose you have the one point. I will take this one as x, y, z. How to represent this point in vector form? I will take one point here, that is origin 0, 0, 0. I will join this with this point x, y, z. Now I can able to find the vector representation of this point, that is x, I vector unit vector plus y, j unit vector plus z, k unit vector. This is the vector representation of this point. Till now, we represented the point vector. We represented the point vector. And also the vector of a line, the representation of vector of a line. Till now, we are not calculated, not find the equation of the line. Here, a line is uniquely determined if, first one, it passes through a given point and has given direction. Suppose, this is your three-dimensional, this is your x, this is your y, and this is your z-axis. And this here I will take one point, 5, 2, 3, and here one line is passing through this point. It passes through a line which is passes through this point with some direction. Then we can find a equation of the line. This is a vector. This is a vector form of the line, and this is a line which is passes through this point. And we can able to find the equation of the line when it passes through a given point and has some given direction. And second one, it passes through two given points. Suppose you have two points, x1, y1, z1, and x2, y2, z2. This is joined by some line. This is your three-dimensional, this is your x, this is your y, and this is your z. So at that time also, you are able to find the equation of the line. Our next derivation is the equation of a line through a given point and parallel to a given vector B. This is the rectangular coordinate axes, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. This is the given point A Now I will find its position vector here. Let A be the position vector. Here we join this point A with the origin 0, 0, 0. And here B is the given vector. I will draw one line which is parallel to the given vector B and passing through the point position vector A. Okay, this is, I will take this one as L vector. This is L. Now I will take one more point here, P, in the line, and I will join this with the origin. This is, I will take it as R vector, having the direction. See here, let A be a position vector of the given point A with respect to the origin O of the rectangular coordinate system. Let L be the line which passes through the point A and is parallel to the given vector B. Let R be the position vector of an arbitrary point P on the line. Then this line AP is parallel to the line vector B. So how can I write this AP vector? AP vector is equals to lambda B vector. This is the lambda B vector because both of these are parallel to each other. So that's why I can write this AP as lambda B vector. That is, AP vector is equals to lambda B vector, where lambda is some real number, but we know that from the triangle law of vector addition, how to find this side OP, that is OA plus AP vector is equals to OP vector. That is, OA vector plus AP vector gives you the OP vector from the triangle of vector addition. So OA is what? Is vector A plus AP. AP is lambda times of B vector is equals to OP is position vector R. So R vector is equals to A vector plus lambda B vector is the vector equation of the line. Okay, this is the required vector equation of the line. Vector equation of the line. Here, don't be confused. Here we calculated the equation of this line which is passes through the point A and parallel to the given vector B. Now, the derivation of Cartesian form from vector form. Let the coordinates of the given point A, I will take this one as A as x1, y1, z1. And the direction ratios of the line B, of the line, this line as A, B, C. Consider the coordinates of any point P, this one as X, Y, Z. The coordinates of P as X, Y, Z and the direction ratios of this line vector as A, B, C. Then R vector is equals to, this vector R is equals to, how can I write in vector form? Xi plus वाई जे प्लस जेड के यूनिट वेक्टर्स एंड द वेक्टर ए दिस वेक्टर बिकॉज इज हैविंग द कोऑर्डिनेट्स एज एक्स वन वाई वन जेड वन देन राइट इन वेक्टर फॉर्म पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ ए इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स वन आई वेक्टर प्लस वाई वन जे वेक्टर प्लस जेड वन के वेक्टर एंड द वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल्स टू हियर ए बी सी आर द डायरेक्शन रेशियोज सो दिस कैन रिटन एज ए आई वेक्टर प्लस बी जे वेक्टर प्लस सी के वेक्टर नाउ सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग दीज वैल्यूज ऑफ आर वेक्टर ए वेक्टर एंड बी वेक्टर इन दिस इक्वेशन यू विल गेट द एक्स आई वेक्टर प्लस वाई जे वेक्टर प्लस जेड के वेक्टर इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स वन आई वेक्टर प्लस वाई वन जे वेक्टर प्लस जेड वन के वेक्टर प्लस लैम्डा बी वेक्टर इज हियर दिस वन दैट इज ए आर प्लस बी जे प्लस सी के नाउ इक्वेटिंग the coefficients of I vector, J vector and K vector, I vector, J vector, K vector from the both the sides, we get x is equals to, see the coefficients of x, I vector, x is equals to x1 plus lambda into A and y is equals to y1 similarly equating the coefficient of J vector, y is equals to y1 plus lambda times of b and similarly equating the coefficient of k vector z is equals to z1 plus lambda c now eliminate lambda from these three equations here lambda is equals to you will get take this x1 this side becomes x minus of x1 lambda a is there I want only lambda it becomes x minus of x1 by a Similar way, this lambda is equals to y minus y1 by b and this lambda is equals to z minus z1 by c. So, here we removed the lambda from these three equations. We get lambda is equals to x minus x1 by a, y minus y1 by b, z minus of z1 by c. These all are the values of lambda. So, now we equate, that is, we get x minus of x1 by a is equals to y minus of y1 by y minus of y1 by b is equals to z minus of z1 by c. These are parametric equation of the line. Here we eliminated the parameter lambda. We get x minus of x1 by a, y minus of y1 by b, z minus of z1 by c. This is the Cartesian equation of the line. This equation is called Cartesian equation of the line. Suppose in place of here direction ratios, here in place of direction ratios ABC of the line, suppose L, M, N are the direction cosines of the line is given in place of direction ratios suppose direction cosines are given L M N then our equation of the line in Cartesian form becomes x minus of x1 by L is equals to y minus of y1 by M is equals to z minus of z1 by N thank you